The president's message was delivered by the Prime Minister of Uganda, Robinah Nabbanja, at the ongoing COP28 at the United Nations Climate Summit at the closure of the first part of the high-level segment of heads of state and governments in Dubai, United Arab Emirates. In his message, President Museveni reveals that recently some parts of the country experienced floods, landslides and prolonged drought with rising temperatures, yet the country contributes only 0.01% of global emissions.
Therefore, appeal to partnerships to offset these climate change costs. Uganda is mindful of the rampant degradation and the associated impacts escalating climate change. As a result, the government of Uganda has come up with policies to protect and preserve our environment and biodiversity.
According to the president, Uganda is mindful of the rampant degradation and the associated impacts of climate change. As a result, the government has come up with policies to protect and preserve the environment. The Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, used the opportunity to invite heads of state and governments attending the summit to come and participate in the 19th Non-Aligned Movement, the G77 and China Summit that Uganda will be hosting in January 2024.
I assure you that as chair of the group, Uganda shall continue to champion the interests of the group to ensure that we get the necessary means of implementation to address the climate change crisis. Your Excellencies, finally, I have the honor to report that the preparations for hosting the third South Summit of the G77 and China in Kampala, Uganda, from 21st to 23rd January, being finalized.
The Prime Minister later made presentations at the side event organized by the International Organization for Migration, where over 33 countries have signed the Kampala Ministerial Declaration on Migration, Environment and Climate Change, which outlines concerns on the effects of climate change on human mobility. The Prime Minister assured the world of the country's commitment in environmental protection.
It is our hope and belief that the Kampala Declaration will serve as a continental reference document for managing the nexus between immigration and climate change.
The International Organization for Migration Director, General Ami E. Pope, says that the world should not look on as young people are suffering.
That we are not going to stand by as people's lives are put at risk, as people's livelihoods are eroded, as people's futures grow dim. That we instead are working together to deliver on something that will change their future.
Nabbanja later in the day also made a presentation at the NAM sideline event meeting organized by Cuba. At the NAM meeting, Nabbanja said there is need for urgent funding of all interventions aimed at environment conservation.
Uganda is developing its energy transition plan and intends to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions by at least 24.5% by the year 2030. The mitigation work program could support this process.
Last evening, Uganda was announced as one of the countries that will benefit from the $100 million grant to strengthen food security systems in Africa.
Uganda, the $10 million grant is going to be focused on post-harvest handling. Uganda has been losing about 40%. Especially for maize, 40% through post-harvest handling. So this is a very welcome announcement.
The Prime Minister was accompanied by several ministers that include Sam Cheptoris, the Minister for Water and Environment, the Minister for Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Ocheng, the Minister for Energy and Mineral Development, Dr. Ruth Nankabira, Beatrice Anywa, the Minister of State for Environment, Okello Oryem, the Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, among others. The summit continues until 12th of December 2023. Report compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news.